It's Punchlines, now with aloe to soothe your summer sunburn.
Let me just grab a pen, a good pen.
Welcome to Punchlines and our weekend wrap. Historically huge hurricanes, cities ablaze because of yet more police violence, a very fiery GOP convention, and the killer virus that continues to burn throughout the country. It's summertime, and isn't the living supposed to be easy?
Ladies and gentlemen, leaders and fighters for freedom and liberty and the American dream, the best is yet to come.
Pardoning a convicted felon on national TV. No, not that one. Or that one. Or any of these.
If Joe Biden gets elected, MS-13 is gonna move in next door. But we won't live there anymore because we'll be kicked out of the suburbs. And if we try to go to church, the Democrats will call the cops on us. But there won't be any cops because they defunded the police. So we'll have to take ourselves to prison. But they abolished the prisons. So now all the criminals are out on the streets, which means they can shoot us. But they can't shoot us because the Democrats have taken away all the guns, which means all we can do is fight with our words. But we can't because words have been canceled. I don't know what it means.
So, of course, the big news this week was the GOP convention. The Republican Party stormed into Washington and threw a very unconventional convention.
Joe Biden is not a savior of America's soul. He is the destroyer of America's jobs. And if given the chance, he will be the destroyer of American greatness.
Wow. For a sleepy guy who doesn't leave his basement, Biden's pretty productive.
Another aspect of the GOP convention was, of course, the demonization of Joe Biden, who perhaps is going to do more damage to America than communism, hurricanes, and Shark Week combined.
At least two officers with their guns drawn followed him as he walked around the front of his gray SUV. Then at least seven shots.
He is a white man with a huge gun strapped across his chest with his hands up as you see police vehicles, not one, not two, but three vehicles who are coming towards him.
Why is it that the police decide that some threats must be extinguished immediately while other threats get the privilege of being diffused? I'm asking these as questions, but I feel like we know the answer. The answer is that the gun doesn't matter as much as who is holding the gun. Because to some people, black skin is the most threatening weapon of all.
This American carnage.
Best.
I'm Mike Pence. I alone can fix it.